Sometimes I think it's Joe's child I'm growing here. When Bill was home and we lay in bed at night, I thought of Joe. I dreamt it was Joe's young silver body that I held. And we lay on a bed of twigs and leaves, and his hair shone in the moonlight. No one understands. When I lay with Bill, I knew it was only his outer husk in my bed. But somehow, Joe had found a way to inhabit Bill's body. And that it was really him I lay with, caressing and kissing. Our limbs wound together like tender vines. I believe now he comes to me at night, when I'm alone. Although I wake in a cold bed, but I wake remembering the pleasure of the darkness. And my skin still glows from the warmth of his young body. His hands hold my breast gently and smooth the mound of my belly. And his fingers pry into the secret places beneath. Those are things I could not imagine. Kitty, love, he whispers to me in the night. Kitty, my love. And I wake with his voice in my ear. He's been through the fire, my Joe, and found his way back to me. Oh, God, Joe. We've blighted our lives, all of us. We will not escape this time. They'll hunt us down and corner us and put fire to us and set us screaming in pain and fear. And the women and the girls will be left, as always, with dryness ever at the back of their throats and dark spaces in our heads where the flames crackle and echo. Golden fire whooshes through the cracks of our mind. Oh, Joe, why did you leave me? Why did you let them take you and defile you? And why will you not leave me now? Must I drag myself after you, burning in my brain for the rest of my life?